Hello everyone and welcome to the next lesson of Java programming language. In the previous lesson we have looked at some general information about Java programming language and also we have set up the environment in which we can write our Java programming course, which is IntelliJ IDEA. Now in this lesson I am going to show you how to start a new project and how to write our first program, and also we will discuss a little bit about the variables. So first of all, when you open up the IntelliJ IDEA, so you have to go to the file menu, go to the new and click on project. In this part of the window, you can select the language in which you want to write your codes in. I am leaving it as default because Java is already selected. Click on next. In this part, check this checkbox. This will create the simple project template which contains the primary codes of Java, which contains the main method and also a class in the project name as well. So then click on next. In this part you have to select the name for your project. For example, I want to name this project as second project. Here you have to select the project location where you want this project to be saved, and also you can select here the package name. Here if we look a little bit further, so a project contains multiple packages and each package contains multiple classes, and a collection of these things create a project. But now you don't have to worry about these things because as you go further you will get familiar with each of these things. So for now I'm leaving it as default. Click on finish, and here you can see the IntelliJ IDEA asks me whether to open the new project in this window or you want that to be opened in a new window. So I'm selecting that in a new window, and there you go, the new project is created in the IntelliJ IDEA. So for now click at this part, close this. Here you will see a directory by name of src. Expand this directory. Here you can see the com.company. We have selected this name for our package. So this is the package which contains one class just for now, because we haven't created any other class, and this class is automatically created by the IntelliJ IDEA. So I'm going to double click on this. Here you can see the primary codes which are needed for a Java project to be run. You can see here this first line is the package name in which we have created the main class. Now at this part, as I told you in the first lesson, Java is a fully object-oriented language. That is because even a very small code of Java must contain a class. Class is the most important part of the object-oriented programming. And also beside the class, it is the name of class. When we want to have access to a class, we have to call its name. So this name refers to this class. And also this public here, it is a part of object oriented. But for now, you don't have to worry about each of these things. We will talk about each of them with more details in the coming lessons. Also here we have main method. This public says that this method is accessible wherever you want to access this. And the static is also has its own meaning. White and main is the name of this method. We will discuss each of this word in the function lesson. This is the basic and required method in every Java program. For example, if I write something and I want to run the program, so I need to have the main method. Here I want to simply print out a sentence. Now I want this sentence to be printed out in the console. So I'm running my program. You can see here our program runs successfully and we get the result that we want. But if I remove this class here, now I don't have the main method. When I run this program, you can see the run icon is removed from here. And also if I click here, I will get an error here, because the program basically need a main method to run. Without that, it's impossible to run our program. So I'm going to write back that. Now if I build my program again, you can see the error is eliminated. Another thing I want to mention here is this, that each of a class and a method has a bracket in which all of the statements of that class or that method are exist there. And each of the statement ends in a semicolon. This semicolon says the Java interpreter that this statement is finished here. Now if I remove this, you can see it gets an error and says that I don't know where you have finished your statement. Show me the end point. So for that you have to add a semicolon here. And also to run your program in IntelliJ IDEA, you have multiple choices. You can right click on the screen and click on run button, and also you can click here on the run button, and also it has a shortcut here, you can see Shift+F10, which will run our project. There you go. Now let's discuss about variables. So variable, as its name implies, it is a thing which can take different values. For example, if I define a variable by the name of x equal to 10. Now this x is a variable which has the value 10. What does it mean? It means that a place in the memory is allocated to this variable by the name of x, and this value which is 10 is assigned in that specific location by the name of x. Now here, if we write x equal to 12, it means that this 12 is now the value which is assigned in this x. This 10 is removed from this specific location by the name of x in the memory. That's why it is called variable. In variable, we have two things, definition and initialization. Definition means we have to define which type of variable we are using or we are creating. And that can be defined by the data type, which we will discuss about that in the coming lessons with details. But for now, I want to write just, for example, int x. Now this x is a variable of the type int. Here we just defined to the interpreter of the Java that we have created a variable by the name of x. A place by the name of x is allocated in the memory. This is called definition of variable. Now, initialization is when we assign a value to this variable. For example, I assign 10. Now, this variable is initialized. What does it mean? It means that this 10 is assigned in this allocated position in the memory by the name of x. And if we talk about the importance of variable, variables are the most important thing in a project or in a program. You won't find any program which contains less than 10 or 15 variables, because this is variable which makes our data usable. For example, if I don't have this variable here by the name of x, how can I assign this 10 in the memory? I'm unable to do this without variable. So variable is very essential in every program. And for printing out the variable, you have to use system.out.println. X, Shift+F10. You can see here the program is running now. There you go. This is the word that we have printed here in this line, and this is the value of the variable that we have assigned here. And this was all for this lesson. Hope you enjoy and learn. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and share the video with your friends if you really want them to learn Java programming language. And also, if you didn't watch the previous lessons, so make sure to watch them to have a better understanding from the start till the end. See you in the next lesson.